32 Life Principles, Section 3, Strategic Vision. Without vision, people perish. Without vision, people do not know where they should go. Without vision, life will not have purpose or meaning. So in this section, we are going to see four principles. Principle 9, springs eternal. That is the work of the Holy Spirit. Principle 10, springboard. A swimmer has to use the springboard to achieve the optimum effect. The third is, that is principle 11, is sailing resource. Principle 12 is successors. So if you want to achieve something in your life, you need a vision. And that vision should spring from the spring eternal, that is the Holy Spirit. So without Holy Spirit, we cannot accomplish anything in this world. So the Spirit of God should renew our mind and help us to focus and be steadfast and go and achieve what we want to achieve. So the Spirit of God gives us the stamina, the strength, the motivation, or as Paul puts it, compulsion. The love of God is poured in our hearts through Holy Spirit. So in Romans 5 we read this. So the love of God compels us to do great things for God. So the love of God, the Holy Spirit, gives us the fruit of the Spirit. Not only that, the gifts of the Spirit. So both are essential. Some people emphasize on gifts of the Spirit, ignoring the fruit of the Spirit. The Lord Jesus Christ said clearly, a tree will be known by its fruit. So the fruit of the Spirit is essential. So the Spirit directed life, Spirit dominated life is essential to be successful. Principle 10 is springboard. So a swimmer has to position himself in the springboard in such a way so that he can make optimum effect. So in our context, God gives us open doors. The principle we have to learn is, whenever we see an open door, we have to enter into it. We should not miss open doors. Many times we knock at doors which are not open, but miss the open doors. So God provides open doors in our lives. So that adds meaning to our life, that gives ministry in our life. If we miss them, then we will lose the real blessings from the Lord. So we have to look for open doors. Then also Lord taught us knocking at the doors. Sometimes the doors may not be open. If we knock, it will be open. So we have to take the step of faith and knock at the door. And also, there may be doors which seems to be closed, but not actually closed. You have to just push it. So you have to push open the doors. So if you want to be successful, whatever open door God gives us, we have to use it. When we were missionaries in North India, so we were never involved in the ministry to children. So we usually work among the adults. But we found that there was a need in Church of North India, in Jagadhri, in Haryana, where there was no vacation Bible schools. So then we invited our pastor to dinner where we gave him dosa and spoke with him about the vacation Bible school. He was excited. He said, let us have a vacation Bible school for 25 children. We ordered books for 25 children. But what happened was there were 55 children. The next year it was 100. So the children who studied, learned in the vacation Bible school later became teachers of vacation Bible school. So when we see an open door, we have to enter into it. God will honor our faith. Principle 11 is sailing resource. I put it as a sailing resource because it is time. Time always moves on, whether we like it or not. We cannot save time. We cannot borrow time. We cannot buy time. We cannot sell time. So time is a gift of God. So we have to optimally use every time. So the time has to be managed according to our priorities, and we should know what is our prime time and use it, and we have to plan our time. So then we will be using it for the glory of God. So use every opportunity, use every moment for the kingdom of God. So the principle 12 is successors. Anything without successor is not a success. So we need to multiply ourselves. It should not be based on our own family. Some people have successors only their family members, so or only their caste members, or only the language speakers. So we should have a broader kingdom attitude to spot out potential successors, whatever language they may speak, whatever caste they may belong, whatever nation they may be. So we should bring them under their wings, under our wings, develop them, groom them, and help them to blossom, so that our vision is multiplied and it is carried by those successors. So we need strategic vision. For that we need the springs eternal, which is Holy Spirit, the springboard, wisdom of using all the open doors, the sailing resource of using all our time, and having a vision to have people to be mentored who will become successors. May God bless you.